Hello everyone. This video continues the discussion about the setup, configuration, and use of the iFIX OPC UA server. Today, we're going to talk about how to set up secure communications. This is one of the key features of OPC UA and allows you to establish secure connections to the iFIX OPC UA server from clients on different machines within your network. So to start with, let's go back to our iFIX workspace, and we've opened up the OPC UA server configuration utility. And in there, as we've discussed in previous videos, there's a security tab where you specify what types of secure connections and policies that you will allow clients to connect through to our server. So in this case, we've enabled basic 256 SHA security policies and none of the other ones for this demo. So this demo will demonstrate how to exchange certificates so that both a server and a client can trust each other through this security policy. In subsequent videos, we will talk about how to connect through a global discovery server and go into detail about some of these other buttons. But for now, on this OPC UA server, we have a self-signed certificate, you can see here. And so when we use self-signed certificates, there has to be a somewhat manual exchange of certificates between a client and server to indicate that they trust each other. So currently in my setup, I have no certificates configured. You can see in my certificate folder under the iFIX install folder, we have a UA folder under the local folder and a PKI server folder where we can place our trusted certificates. You can see there's nothing in that trusted certificate folder right now. So right now we don't trust anybody. So I'm going to pull up an OPC UA client. This is the Simplicity OPC UA client. And in here we've already browsed the iFIX server and specified that we want to talk through the basic SHA 256 SHA policy. So if I test that connection, you can see that the error message indicates that this server isn't trusted on this client side. And so it starts, the client first needs to trust the server, and then the client will try to connect to the server, and then the server has to again trust back on that client. So if we go look in the Simplicity PKI folder and look under rejected, you'll see we have a couple certificates here. One is a new one. If we look, we can open up the certificate and take a look at it, and you can see this is our fix, CCSI fix demo machine where that our iFIX server is running. So we can verify that's a certificate we want to trust. We'll cut it out of here. You don't want it to remain in the rejected folder. And go to the trusted folder under the certs folder and copy or cut and paste that into the trusted folder. Now, if I go and try to connect from the client to the server again, you see a bit of a different message. You can see that security checks failed when the client tried to go to the server. So it went to the server, got the server certificate and said, oh, I trust that server. But the server came back and said, I don't trust you. So now what we have to do is go back to iFIX. And it typically, in the case of Simplicity, we had to go to the folder system. In iFIX, newly added for this OPC UA server, we've built the trust management list for this scenario into the tool. So you can see we have a trust list here, and you can actually select, you see this appeared, you can select and take a look at this certificate, and you can see this is the Simplicity client that just tried to connect, and we indicate that we don't trust it yet. But if I've looked at that certificate and determined that it's trustworthy, I can hit the trust button here. A little bit of a warning, it is important to make sure you trust whoever you want to talk to, say yes. Now we trust it. So both the server and client trust each other. And now let's go back to the client and one more time hit that test connection. And you can see everything is good. Now we both trust each other And if I want to make sure communications are happening, close this down. Just double check that. And we can see that the communication is happening, and it's happening over a secure policy channel.